On the surface, it's shaped as a holiday made in heaven, but for the Wildcats, it was nothing less than 2.5 days of hell.
But there'll be times during this camp that you'll say, I want to go home. There'll be times during this camp you'll say, I've had enough.
Vital if you want to be a successful team.
Don't want to hear it. Heads up. Push up position. Black one, he said leave it there until they say.
No contact with the outside world, the constant squawk and talk of the coaches forbidden. Scott Fisher not allowed within 10 metres of his team. It wasn't long before the torturous test took over. A morning of madness putting these professional sportsmen under the pump.
Come on!
Two teams with stringent rules to abide by.
There'll be no swearing at any time.
2.5 hours in, the first 2.5 hours are always intense. That's the idea, really up the ante early on. Find the weaknesses of the players and really expose those. So if there's somebody good in exercise, we'll certainly stop that and find something different.
You know I did it, it's over and I feel fine. Nothing you can say is gonna change my mind. Waited and I waited the longest night. Nothing like the taste of sweet decline.
Aaron Trahair sinking in the sand, possibly ruining his decision to rejoin the Cats instead of heading to the Singapore Slingers.
I wouldn't say they do a lot of soft sand running, let's say that. We had a few issues with that and a few little tears early on, but they got through that.
A change of environment and base in a secret location, but the Cats were barely allowed to lick their wounds. Camp Cam following their every groan, grumble and gripe over two nights.
It's a shame.
They call him the curly hair crusader,
yeah.
Captain Crunch.
The players' determination sure to make their fans proud. Like the Kangaroos in the AFL this season, mental toughness will be their weapon.
They're very different in physiques, explosive athletes, but at the end of the day, it's that mental drive. And you can see that at the end where they were challenged on a couple of exercises and they managed to find something. And that's the same with all athletes, so they're great to work with.
Not sure whether the boys will have the same view on IDQ. Their response to this camp, not to be missed tomorrow night.
My heart is under arrest again, but I break loose. My head is giving me life or death, but I can't choose. I swear I'll never give in. I refuse.
That was the best thing I've ever done, I reckon. That was absolutely awesome. It was by far the hardest thing I've ever done, but it was incredibly rewarding. And I can safely say that I know the measure of every single player in the Perth Wildcats.
Australians, all let us rejoice.
We wrote in our diaries every day, I bet. At the end of each entry, I've said, I do not want to be here.
20 minutes in, Lockie, it was excruciating.
For the Mavericks. Team rules, gentlemen, vital if you want to be a successful team.
You know, 25k walking, you know, quicksand it felt like, and the fence dips. I think you may have caught some footage of fence dips today. I mean, that is at 4:40 in the morning. So after getting 40 minutes sleep prior to that.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Night time, we would, you know, have to go on these walks with our packs, and you just start hallucinating.
Ended up falling asleep while you're standing up, which is a pretty weird feeling because it's like you're in a real life dream, and I was running around seeing things and talking to people that weren't actually there, and but you don't think it can happen until it actually happens.
Next few minutes, we will take what's rightfully ours, and that's the championship.
Rashad Phillips was unbelievable. You know, I literally had him coming out of there in a body bag. But you know, after the first half an hour, he collapsed once and had to be helped back up. And after that, there was no quit.
I'm actually terrified of ocean water, and I had to go out on the deep end of the ocean by myself and kayak. But I did that for my teammates to show them that I will go out on a limb for them beyond my fears.
Scott was a bystander, so he was just watching with an awful smug look on his face. Just
the last thing they did in there inside Challenge Stadium, it was all I could do to hold myself together. It was incredibly moving, and I'm so proud of these guys, and they haven't even played a game yet.